Good evening, everyone, and welcome back to E3 2017. This is going to be the Bethesda late night edition, apparently, because they're crazy people. And once again, Darth Shady is going to be joining me for this one. So, how are you doing?
I'm doing well. How about you?
Oh, pretty good. Now, before we get into Bethesda, I actually want to ask your opinion about Microsoft's, because you did get a chance to see that one. So, what were your what was your thoughts on that one compared to EA?
Well, I liked the format. I liked the rhythm because they had some introduction before, and then they went right into it. It was content, 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 and it was very strategic the way people would come to speak, and it wasn't all the time, and they spoke for, what, maybe a minute, 2 minutes, not more than that. So I found that really good, and they just showed trailer after trailer, and that was pretty cool. So the pace was good, and the trailer, as you know, that sad owl thing, I got teary-eyed, and then later when my husband came home, I told him about the trailer with the owl, and I started crying. so I was like, oh, it's so sad. It was the montage was so well built that it wasn't the way that they did it with the order that they did it was able to move us, was able to move me, because they didn't just do something that wasn't related to something else. They kind of built it up. And that's probably why I could, you know, I got so into it, and I was feeling for all the characters that I was seeing in all these trailers.
Yep.
Yeah.
Well, just to go over Bethesda here a little bit. So, for those who don't know, the Bethesda conference is actually fairly new. They've only done it for 2 or 3 years. And Bethesda, as a company themselves, they don't really have that many IPs. They have grown a little bit over the last couple of years. But over the last 2 years, they have really burned through a lot of their IPs. I mean, if we can go through the list off the top of my head here, you know, they have released, like last year as an example, they had Doom, they had Dishonored 2, Quake is currently in development, we saw that, that's currently in beta. The year before that was stuff like Fallout. And so it's kind of up in the air a little bit on exactly what they're going to show this year. It sounds like we're probably going to finally get another Elder Scrolls. So a lot of people are really excited about that. But kind of beyond that, it's a little bit of a mystery on what we may or may not see tonight. There's been a lot of rumors talking about a new IP that they're going to have. It's some sort of open world sci-fi RPG thing. I think it's called Starfield. So we might see that tonight, hopefully. But kind of other than that, I don't know what they're going to talk about for like an hour and hour and a half, hour 15, or whatever it is. So
I heard that there were like two unknowns that they were going to maybe talk about. So that would be interesting. Maybe the first one is Starfield, like you said, and maybe the second one is something completely new. We'll see.
Yeah, and it was announced last year that they're doing Fallout VR, so there's the possibility that we might see something on that.
Yeah. So, we'll just have to wait and see what they've got for us.
Yep. Yeah, so it should be starting here in just a couple of minutes. We'll keep an eye on it here.
Yeah, there's these interviews going on, so.
Yeah, another game that they just released from their library was Prey, so that was another one we can kind of check off the list, because I was sitting here trying to think of what other other IPs that I may have forgotten from their list, and that was another one.
Yeah.
Wolfenstein is another, so there's rumors tonight of a new Wolfenstein.
Because that's currently in the works, right?
Possibly, yeah.
Yeah.
Because the last release on that was 3 or 4 years ago, I think. And I know that one in particular, a lot of people thought that was a Game of the Year contender. I actually haven't, but haven't had a chance to play it yet. Okay, it looks like we are actually going to be starting here. They got a timer going now. Do you got that on your end?
I don't see the timer. Oh, hang on. I don't see the
They
timer.
just they just flipped away. It's about 20 seconds. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to kick on the audio.
All
We're
day,
going to
no stuff.
Bethesda. We'll see you.
All right, it's officially starting now.
What does your
We're
daddy
showing
do?
Little kids
What does
running
he do
around.
for a job?
Plays on
I
his
think I'm
computer.
20 seconds
I don't
behind.
know. I don't know, actually. He does effects
I'm
like
seeing the
sparkles,
10-second
cutscenes.
Right. What if you do a refresh on your screen?
Does
Would that maybe catch you up?
I'm a senior programmer.
I'm a UI programmer.
I'm a senior designer.
My mom's an artist.
Yep, we're going
she
full screen.
Pretty hard.
I am a quest designer.
I'm a awesome. Senior character artist.
Yeah, it definitely is a very familial environment.
My dad makes video games.
Also, once again,
My
for those of you in chat, if you can help
games.
Me with the audio, make
I
sure we're
always
synced
wanted
up.
To make games.
I dreamt of this kind of job when I was a kid.
I grew up loving games.
When he was little, this was actually his dream job.
It never occurred to me that it could be a job.
Sometimes I still feel like that kid.
I mean, I'm an adult.
Sometimes I have to pinch myself that it's real.
I love what I do.
I mean, it's video games for a living. That's gotta be really cool.
Of course.
My dad's games make people feel happy.
Scared. Excited.
Badass. All kinds of feelings.
I'm actually working on an RPG.
I'm working on a shooter.
It's a really cool mobile game.
Esports.
First person, third person.
Fantasy. Mobile game. Dystopian.
A horror game.
It'll scare the shit out of you.
Rah!
Hang on.
Finally showing everyone our game is really exciting.
Awesome. Scary.
Overwhelming.
Mind-blowing.
I'm really proud of my dad.
My mom worked hard.
And now they're ready.
They made their game. And this is it. It's go time.
Time to show everyone what we've been working on.
Except me. I can't play till I'm older.
Awesome.
Kind of
Let's
sounds
get
like
it started.
They're going to show the new
Are
IP.
You ready?
Oh, yeah.
So let's just say it.
Start the show.
Start the show.
Showtime.
Showtime. I don't know what showtime is.
Were you able to get it synced up any better?
Welcome.
Welcome.
I think so.
Showcase.
Yeah, right now they got the pictures going into the logo. That's what I'm seeing.
I'm still seeing people talking. I just had kids saying Showtime. By how behind am I?
Probably a good 10 seconds.
Wow.
So they're basically just doing the montage now of like every game that we just mentioned in our pre-show.
Basically, yeah. That's what I see.
A lot of Doom, a lot of Fallout, a lot of Dishonored.
Welcome, everyone, to Bethesda Land 2017.
Okay.
Yes, Bethesda Land. A place of adventure, innovation, wonderment, but
this
above
is very
all
Fallout.
Else, fun.
Esque.
Esque, yeah.
To get things started, please welcome Bethesda's Global Vice President of PR and Marketing, Pete Hines.
Their stage looks really similar to last year.
Thank you very much. I can't even imagine the size of the bar tab that it paid for that applause, but I thank you for that. Good evening and welcome to the 2017 Bethesda E3 Showcase. And welcome
Definitely
to Bethesda
has a
Land.
Fallout theme.
We will offer you an experience at E3 unlike anything else, and a chance to celebrate some of the world's best video games. Tonight we'll be taking you on a virtual tour through our playground where there's something for everyone, whether it's phone or tablet, PC, or your favorite Xbox, PlayStation, crazy, or Nintendo console, or like many of us, all of the above. But before we turn to the latest from Bethesda, let's take a minute to look at some of the most recent games that you've been playing and many of you are still enjoying, like the endless hours of fun that millions of fans have had playing Doom.
I've heard that the Doom is really,
ripping,
really
tearing,
good.
Tearing and otherwise eviscerating demons from hell. Did you play a badass supernatural assassin in
neither.
Dishonored 2, or fight to survive aboard an alien-infested space station in Prey? Maybe you're one of the 100 million people around the world who have enjoyed building and overseeing your own vault in Fallout Shelter. And I know that many of you are still playing
also,
Fallout 4 and
Skyrim Special I wonder if
Special
the Elder
Edition.
Scrolls hype lady is going to be here this year.
Probably, because for the first time in our industry, both games offer user mods for consoles.
Last year, there was this lady
with more than 300 million
for Elder Scrolls Online, the MMO.
Since we launched them last year.
Whenever they talk about that, she would just scream
at
the top of her lungs.
Bethesda works hard for you, giving players the very best entertainment experience regardless of your taste.
It was actually so bad, it was actually trending on Twitter for a long time.
What's next? Let's start by talking about virtual reality, something that we've been at the forefront of for a while now. We've had teams hard at work on VR titles to provide the kind of experiences you've been asking for and the kind of experience you won't find anywhere else. So let's start our tour with Bethesda Land
saying the stream
two
is
VR
too loud.
Games coming out
anybody
this
else
year.
Want to confirm that?
You ready?
I'll turn it down a little
let's
bit.
Let's take a look.
Game is this? Is this Doom? Doom VR?
VR titles.
Go ahead and turn it down just a little bit. VFR. This is copyrighted music. I can see it now. Mr. Sandman. It's like an old school song though, so it probably wouldn't be black for a while. One of the big questions for the Fallout VR was, how are you actually walking? Are they doing that via controller?
I'm not sure how that would work.
Finally, a full-length open-world game with near-limitless content playable entirely in VR. Sure will be exciting to play Fallout 4 in VR. Plus, Doom VFR. It's so hot right now. Expansive open worlds and endless player choice are two of the cornerstones on which Bethesda was built. The Elder Scrolls Online, first released in 2014 and has built a massive community. Since launch, more than 10 million players have had countless adventures in Tamriel. Now you can return to a thrilling fan favorite location, Morrowind.
I know a lot of people are pretty happy about that expansion.
What's
news.
Up, guys? It's
James.
It's James.
Yeah.
It's
going to be exciting.
I'm pretty excited right now.
Here we go.
I know a lot of people who are big fans are fans of Fallout.
God,
so.
What the heck?
My heart's like racing right now.
They shot the fans.
Who shoot arrows into that bear?
Better not have killed the bear.
Amazing.
I can't wait.
Audio is always really difficult to do in these streams, guys. Because Zacron just told me to turn it down, and then you're telling me to turn it up, so I don't know what to tell you.
Elder Scrolls Online made me feel like I was 14 again.
I gotta watch the bear again real quick. Get us on the bear.
That was the cinematic from last year, I believe. I just want to make sure we're finding a right balance in audio, so you guys tell me. If it's too low, I'll turn it back up. Hashtag need audio meters. I beta tested Elder Scrolls Online and I haven't touched it since. I thought it was an okay game.
Yeah, I haven't tried the Elder Scrolls yet. Because I know how I get with Dragon Age and with SWTOR, so.
Yeah.
I worry that if I start, I won't stop.
Speaking of Morrowind, did you know that Bethesda's first PC user mods in 2002 were for The Elder Scrolls III Morrowind? 15 years later, Bethesda continues to support the mod community. Last year, Bethesda user mods were made available to Xbox One and PlayStation 4 players. And since then, there have been more than 300 million mod
really
downloads
weird.
For Fallout 4. And
it's
Skyrim Special Edition.
Switching.
And we're just getting started.
Strange.
In 2017, Bethesda is going to shake things up again.
Bethesda Game Studios is known for creating open living worlds with seemingly limitless gameplay content. But what if there was another way to experience even more? Something all new. Introducing Creation Club. A collection of new game content for Skyrim and Fallout 4, including new weapons, new outfits and accessories.
So basically, this is
new
a mod center
and housing features, even new gameplay enhancements. Using Creation Club is easy. Browse the selection in game by category and use credits to download right there. Your new content will appear automatically. Creation Club content is made by Bethesda Game Studios and outside developers, including the very best community creators. These outside creators work hand in hand with Bethesda Game Studios, which means all content will be fully compatible with your save games, achievements,
it's
and
like
official
a mod
add-ons.
DLC.
Creation
yeah.
Club
like a
is coming this
DLC
summer
and
for the PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and PC. Creation Club, the worlds of Fallout 4 and Skyrim, just got a little bit bigger.
The Elder Scrolls Legends is another way to explore this amazing universe, taking you beyond the role-playing experience and offering a unique strategy card game. But we haven't shown all our cards yet. Let's see what's next for Legends.
Yeah, like you said, they are just jumping around all over the place.
Stories can do surprising things.
Yeah, I thought it was just me, but I keep refreshing it.
And this is
maybe
10
seconds
hear.
Behind, but it keeps going back and forth a bit.
Bring me a warrior. Strength and courage.
It's very strange. But interesting.
I've heard that Elder Scrolls Legends is a pretty good card game for people who are into card games.
I heard that from someone who played Magic the Gathering that they found that it was better than RPG.
I have you now.
Wintry North comes a new card.
Even those lost amongst the mountains can find their way within the stars. The path is written for you to find. The path to warriors destined for Sovngarde. To beasts cursed by an unquenchable hunger. To scholars of ancient and ferocious magic. And to dark terrors from above. They all await in Skyrim. You must simply find the path.
Of Skyrim.
Possibly, yeah.
The Elder Scrolls has given tens of millions of fans, just like you, the chance to live another life in another world. Now, for the first time, Skyrim, one of our most beloved games, is coming to a Nintendo platform.
That's not news.
Now that's a switch.
Oh god, Nintendo. They're gonna copyright this whole video. They're evil. We're showing a picture of a Switch. It's like an instant copyright. Yeah, I want Zelda in my Skyrim. I'd be down for that.
Legend of Zelda Elements.
Interesting use of the motion controls there.
Bethesda has always believed
in
immersive
like
worlds in which players can tell
conference.
Their own stories,
yeah.
Be who they want to be, and do what they want to do. This September, get ready for another adventure in the Dishonored universe.
What?
A story of revenge and the ultimate assassination.
Is it Dishonored 2 DLC, or what is this? I didn't see if that was Emily or what character that is. Somebody new, maybe?
Possibly.
Awesome. Oh, it's the ship captain. That's who it is.
Doubt. It's good to see you, old man.
You up for one last job, Billy?
Who's the mark?
The black-eyed bastard responsible for all the chaos.
She's got a robo arm now.
We're gonna kill the outsider.
Death of the outsider. That looks good.
Yeah, that looks good.
In 1996, id Software offered gamers a new, exciting way to play and compete. That year marked the true birth of esports, and it began with a LAN party in Dallas, Texas. Fans came together to play a fast-paced, revolutionary new shooter called Quake. It offered them a new way to compete.
So they're just,
and the best of the best were
like
finally recognized as professional gamers.
Not really getting
this
any
year, Quake
new
Champions
news.
Takes esports to the next
level. No new content yet. Just new versions or add-ons to existing content.
Yeah. Now Quake Champions has not officially been released yet. It's still in beta.
We're made.
So maybe they're going to announce a release date for that.
Made better.
Maybe.
Made faster. Made deadlier. With every single match, we don't just play, we compete. We achieve. We rise.
Maybe they're going to
stop
until
we're the best. Until we are Quake champions.
Coming at you! I am unstoppable.
Juice it up, baby.
Did you see that?
And from what I know about Quake Champions,
what's the matter?
So far, it's getting kind of mixed reviews. Some people really like it, and some don't. But it's definitely got that fast-paced action.
Who's next?
You've done messed up now.
Duckborian saying this is actually an old trailer.
I'm coming for you, goddamn weirdos.
Okay.
None of you gets out alive.
Have they shown anything for... They have showed a little bit from Doom, but not much.
Every match, every frag.
They showed Doom VR.
Every victory.
But here they're like...
More than 20 years in the making, the original eSport returns.
Yeah, I was just going to say, they're
the
promoting
Quake
this as an eSport, and the game's not even
August
out yet.
August 26th at QuakeCon in Dallas, Texas. Competitors will face off in the ultimate eSports arena.
And I think that's because Bethesda does not have an eSport right now. None of their games
and
really
the one thing every
qualify,
champion
I guess.
Seeks.
So this is the one they're trying
Legacy.
To shoe in, I guess.
Play the beta now and get ready for the Quake World Championships. Visit Quake.com to learn more.
You might notice some parts of Bethesda Land have been under construction, but now the work is nearly finished. Let's take a peek.
All right, maybe we're going to get to see something new here.
Maybe.
Bethesda needs to step it up here. This is not going well for them right now. This is by far the worst
Sebastian.
Start.
They're competing with EA, but not in the right direction that they should be competing with.
What you're looking for because they didn't want you to. Mobius knows you've been following us. And they've been watching you for a long time. You trained and trusted me. And in return, I betrayed you. Long before we met, you lost your daughter, Lily.
Why does that symbol look familiar?
She's still alive. This is your chance to save her. get back what you lost. Lily,
I don't recognize this game.
You're gonna need to go back into STEM. Again.
Yeah, I agree. Microsoft's press conference was really good.
Yeah.
Compared to these other ones that we've seen. It was light years ahead.
And we'll see tomorrow what they look like, but...
Yeah, I don't know what this is.
It looks very strange.
And as I try to make my way to the ordinary world, I will learn to survive.
Reminds me of that failed Microsoft game a little bit. Quantum Break.
Oh, yeah.
I think they're also trying to Kojima this trailer. Me of like a music video from the 80s too.
Well, I'm definitely very curious about it.
Oh my. Okay. Gonna make a lot of people really happy.
Yeah.
October too. Oh, Friday the 13th. The Evil Within 2.
Wow. On Friday, October 13th, The Evil Within 2 will surely be giving us all nightmares. We hope you've enjoyed your time in Bethesda Land.
Not really, announcer.
And as we near the end of our tour, we leave you with one more coming attraction.
This better be... something.
Here you go, Peggy. There's everything your mother ordered. And a ration card. And here's a lot
an actual attraction.
Wow. Gee, thanks, Mr. Wilson.
Well, gee willikers.
Hi, Peggy.
Hi, Bill.
Hello, Paul.
Jeebers, mister. That's great.
What'd you do to your truck, sir?
I'm going to get you out.
Get it off.
Hang on, I'm going to get you out.
Where's the sheriff? What? Oh my God.
What is this?
Legal, help!
Look out!
Good girl, Legal. Bravo!
This is not where I thought this was going.
No! No! Stop it, Diesel! Bad girl.
Beat the truck.
Really? That's a. Is that actually a game?
State security.
Wunderbar soldier who ever lived.
Power of wonder.
Welcome back to round three. Now is where it gets really exciting on America's number one game show.
I just can't stop.
Okay, hands on your buzzers. Here we go.
The honorable you would exercise.
This just keeps getting weirder. Rafferty, you joined at the best time. This is the weirdest stuff.
Maybe this is why they wanted to do it at this time.
Because everybody's drunk and we have no idea what's happening.
Maybe I should start getting drunk right now. You were sweet.
The old and the weak are doomed.
Normally it's the Ubisoft press event that's a joke. That's usually the one that everybody laughs at.
William.
Well, it's definitely hilarious, that's for sure.
And the tone has all of a sudden just changed.
It keeps changing.
So it says we're having twins.
Frau Engel, she's been hunting for you. She's been moving heaven and earth, and today she found you.
Oh, this has got to be Wolfenstein, right?
Your hero, William Joseph.
Yep, this has got to be the next Wolfenstein.
Monsters did this.
Could be.
Not monsters.
Yeah, there's Nazi stuff.
Have you taken your German lessons?
Hello?
Come on, Peter, let's go someplace else.
Mom, we
no
have
buts!
Any... Oh! Bitte schön.
Danke. Come on.
You, one strawberry milkshake, please. Oh. I hope you don't have a fire back there to put
don't
out.
Don't fourth wall this thing.
If so, I'll come back another
They're
time.
They're doing it.
I'm sure the fire can wait,
Definitely.
Commandant. One strawberry milkshake coming right up.
Fireman, I recognize your face. Very Aryan face it is, too. Are you out of station
Actually,
one?
Actually, I think he's just talking to somebody else.
There you go, Commandant.
Oh, vielen Dank.
Your character. He's talking to your character.
Yeah.
Now you, show me your identification papers.
No.
Please.
I better show you nothing.
We gotta put the fighting spirit back in the American people.
So this is like alternate universe. Future, it looks like.
Yeah.
Just who the fuck are you,
it's almost like
white
a sci-fi.
Boy?
Stay calm. Let me first make it absolutely
As
clear that I am
future
not
a Nazi. Had the
Germans you say you're Nazi?
Oh, fuck
yeah.
This.
I think so.
Let me say this again. I ain't no goddamn Nazi.
Hey! Now you bring Super Spech back in and you put him down right now, or I will shove this grenade
this
so far
This is some
up
cool
your
trick,
ass.
Though.
Lady. I got precious little time for your bullshit. We've been trying to make contact with your group. We're organizing for a revolution in America.
We? Shit!
Take cover!
Relax, man. It's just a duck.
Oh, bitch got a sick sense of humor.
For the longest time, I've been hearing through the grapevine about this resistance. Leader. Horton.
You know, my ma always said, never trust a man can't handle his whiskey. So you sit right down, sit there, Billy, and Drink up.
Oh, goddamn.
Now listen, Terry Billy, I respect your ambition, but there's nothing can be done no more. The world has sank into the crapper, and all we can do now is drink this whiskey and watch the vortex suck it all down.
Didn't expect your belly to be quite so yellow.
We stood up against the imperialist war machine of the United States of America and the greedy money men of Wall Street who was itching to send the children of the proletariat off to die in foreign lands so that they could be filling their coffers. It worked, their sons bleeding on the beaches.
I got kids on the way, and I'll be damned if I'm gonna raise them in a world run by these Nazi assholes.
You take freedom away from the American people, you're playing with fire. And I intend to pour some gasoline.
So far, this looks really good.
Yeah.
I really,
so far, the best trailer we've seen.
Yeah, I really need to go back and play the last one. Colossus. There we go.
New boss, monsters.
Hey, little fella.
What the?
What are you doing here? It's dangerous here. You have to be so quiet. Welcome.
Okay, all right.
I said a couple of months ago that the thing that Machine Games was working on is fucking bananas.
Well,
so now you know what I mean by fucking bananas. A lady pregnant with twins stabbing a Nazi while a guy is dropping acid is fucking bananas.
Yeah,
we
those
can't wait to more show, to
games
show
are a little over the top.
Wolfenstein 2 and how it combines
well,
a compelling shooter
bananas.
With great story, unforgettable characters, and killer graphics with over-the-top action. So if you visit our booth this week at E3, you have a chance to go hands-on and begin the fight to rally the resistance in America against the Nazi regime. In addition to Wolfenstein 2, we'll have hands-on for our VR titles, so you can play both Fallout 4 and Doom VFR. You can play Quake Champions and start practicing for that big million-dollar prize pool at QuakeCon. Or you can try the Battlegrounds mode in the new Elder Scrolls Online Morrowind. Plus, we have hands-on for the new Heroes of Skyrim for Legends, plus a cool interactive experience for The Evil Within 2, exclusive developer interviews, presentations, and a lot more. So we hope you're as excited for what we have coming in 2017 as we are. Again, a reminder, everything that you saw tonight will be out this year. Be it mobile or PC, console or virtual reality, shooter, horror, RPG, action, or strategy card game, we believe Bethesda will remain the place to go for the very best in video games. We hope you've enjoyed this evening's showcase. It's your passion and excitement that
they're not
drives
done
our
yet.
Teams
There's no
to
way.
Make something great, something exciting, something fun. If
it's
you're here at E3, we hope you'll come by the booth and say hi. If you're not here
so
in LA,
like a half hour.
Please keep seeing BethesdaNet, where we'll have lots more to say about the games you saw tonight in the coming days, weeks, and months. And we thank all of you online for joining us. Please have a good night.
No. There's no way this was only a half hour. I don't believe this. I don't believe this.
At this time slot. Only half an hour at this time slot.
This has got to be a goof. If this was only a half hour, this is the shortest conference I've ever seen.
And they kept jumping. from?
Hold on.
This
we're
is so weird.
We're. I'm gonna turn down the music here a little bit, but. I'm having a difficult time believing that this is actually over. So let's bring. I'm gonna go to camera view as we watch this. I cannot believe that this was a half hour.
They so didn't. I'm at a loss for words.
I think this was worse than EA.
I think they were competing with EA, but like in the negative direction.
Yeah, it's.
And it. They kept. I don't know if it was just me, but they kept clipping with that weird Fallout type narrator scenery guy. And then from something else, and then doo 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 da 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 da, 50s style music, and then back, and then it kept jumping.
Yeah, that was. For those who don't know, I take E3 off every single year. I have watched these conferences and covered these for well over 5 years. This is the weirdest conference I've ever seen. I've never seen a conference like that. And 30 minutes, I've never. I'm speechless.
It was definitely laughable. It was funny because it was so weird. And maybe this was their goal. I mean, if their goal was to make it so weird that people would remember it and talk about it,
yeah,
then they've succeeded.
Yep.
Some of the commercials that play on TV, the ones we remember, are the most weirdest ones that make absolutely no sense.
Mm-hmm.
So it could be a marketing strategy.
Yeah. So really, there's only two things to talk about. And that was that they announced The Evil Within 2.
And Wolfenstein 2.
Yep, that's it.
Because they didn't, other than the open world, more open world stuff about Morrowind and the VR for Fallout and Doom and that new card. the winter thing.
Yeah.
Otherwise, so why did they do it at midnight?
I have no idea. That was just, that was crazy, guys. But no, the new Wolfenstein, that game looked good.
It was by far the best trailer of the block. It was the best trailer. It looks the characters sound great. It looks pretty decent.
Mm-hmm.
And the trailer gave enough of the concept of the game, the scenery, the setting, and everything. The other trailer was a little, it was good, but it was a little, gave away less.
Yeah.
I saw in the chat, Spice Lord says midnight is probably cheaper.
Novik, are you still in chat? I'd love to hear what you have to say about that. That craziness. And as we're waiting for that, I'll go ahead and pull up the schedule here.
Yes, Swartor Valkorion. We stayed up for that.
Yeah. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be doing 3 of these tomorrow. So tomorrow is going to be a very fun day. The PC Gaming Show, that is also a little bit of a wild card. That show is also very new. They've only done it 2 years. And it's also very different. If you ever see any of the late night talk shows, you know, like Jimmy Fallon or any of those, the PC Gaming Show is actually like that. It's actually like Day 9 has a desk and he brings out people and they talk about their games and that's kind of that show. But Ubisoft and Sony will be like the Microsoft one. that was held today.
Yeah.
So.
It can't be weirder than what we just saw.
Yeah. Well, Ubisoft maybe can pull it off.
Maybe.
They like to do.
Depends what they're working on.
Yeah, they like to do a lot of dancing at Ubisoft. And the host for Ubisoft is Aisha Tyler. Do you know who she is?
Nope. Well, I've heard of her, but I've never met her.
Yeah. If anybody watches the show Archer, she's the voice of Lana Kane. I know she also is the new host. I don't know if it's still running or not, but she was the host of Whose Line Is It Anyway?
Okay.
For a while.
Okay.
When they brought that show back on WB, I think it was. But she's a really, really good host. She might be the best host out of everybody.
Okay, cool.
Well, I guess that was that, and we'll just go ahead and wrap it up, I suppose. We don't have
much to say.
Yeah, it was weird. It was short.
I did like the animation, though. I liked the concept that they were trying to go with the Fallout feel and everything, but it was a little too jumpy and a little too strange.
Yeah.
And what was that little animation, Bonhomme, at the end, at the end of the trailer, the little cartoon guy? What was that?
Are you talking about Vault Boy, maybe? I'm trying to think of what you're referring to.
The little blue guy.
Yeah, that's...
And then he kind of, like, put him back in his pocket or something.
Oh, that thing. I have no... It was some kind of, like, virtual pet or something like that.
It was very Harry Potter-esque. You know, Fantastic Beasts-esque.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, we'll go ahead and we'll do some shout-outs here. I'll go ahead and throw up your card. If you want to tell people where they can find all your lovely stuff.
All my lovely stuff. You can find it on YouTube. The channel is Darth Shady. And I do a lot of gaming content, mostly Dragon Age-related theories, predictions. I have a lot of interesting stuff if you're obsessed with Dragon Age. I'm obsessed with Dragon Age. So I've been analyzing the Chant of Light, and I'm going to be starting something pretty cool pretty soon that I haven't officially announced yet, so I won't say it.
Secret.
You gotta subscribe so that you can have exclusivity to that content. And I also like to invent drinks, so I have drinks recipes on there. I have some gameplay stuff from SWTOR. I like to do random parodies, so I have some SWTOR random parodies, some other weird stuff, Mass Effect parodies. And I also, since I'm also an indie filmmaker and video producer, I have some little extra stuff if you're into that, and some trailers for my stuff, my work. So go ahead and check that out. You can also follow me on Twitter at BinkyProd. And you can also check out my website, which is more geared towards the Binky production side, what I do and the services I provide and stuff like that. Yep. So that's BinkyProductions.com.
Yeah, very cool. That.
Yeah.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, so we will be live once again tomorrow morning. The PC Gaming Show is going to start at 10 a.m. Pacific. So it'll actually be noon for me. It'll be the first show.
Are you doing that with SWTOR Central?
No, he couldn't make any of the ones on Monday. So,
cool.
I've got one guy who might do one of them, but I'm not sure yet.
Cool.
Got to kind of figure out what the plan is for Monday. But either way, we'll be doing them. They'll be here. So it should be a lot of fun.
SWTOR Valkorion has a good recap of the three we've seen so far, saying that EA was crap, Microsoft was probably the best one, and Bethesda was a WTF one. You know, it's like, what?
Yeah.
You know? It definitely, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. And if I can, I'm trying to get these ported over to YouTube, but the first two that I've done have received massive copyright issues, and so it's going to take time to work through all that stuff. But hopefully, at some point, very, very soon, I'll have all the conferences actually on YouTube for anybody who wants to rewatch or re-see anything or any of that fun stuff.
Or for anyone who didn't see it previously.
Yep.
Well, ideally, potentially this week, having it up would be good.
Yep. Well, any final words before we end this thing?
Yeah, any questions for us before we go?
Yeah, Bloodhunter, Bloodhunter was saying, yeah, Microsoft had a really good conference, but Sony to come. Yeah, Sony has won this thing the last 3 or 4 years. They are just, they know what they're doing.
Yeah.
But the problem I have with Sony this year on why they might get beat is I think the Sony conference is too predictable this year. And that's the first time in forever that I can actually say that.
Possibly, yeah.
Because like I can sit here and say, okay, I think they're going to show God of War. They're going to show the new Spider-Man game. They're going to show Days Gone. They're going to show Detroit Become Human. I think it's been confirmed that Destiny 2 is going to be there. I think it's been confirmed that Red Dead 2 is going to be there. So I just named like 6 or 7 games. So that right there could be their whole conference. So it's been surprises over the last couple years that have won them the show. And I don't know what they've got for surprises.
Well, it wouldn't be a surprise if we knew. So we'll just have to wait and see.
But I would say if they would open up their show with Red Dead Redemption 2, that would be quite the opening.
Yeah.
Bloodhunter saying Red Dead 2 will not be at E3. I'm not so sure. I've seen conflicting reports on that. And a lot of times you can't really trust them when they say that they're not going to be there. Like Kojima last year said he wasn't going to be there, and look what he did. Also, just to, I guess, talk more about that, Kojima also said that he's not doing anything this year. So you can't trust that man.
Yeah.
You just don't know.
And I thought that EA had said that they were going to do something about Dragon Age. Or was that just rumored that we took at face value?
I thought they released some concept art or something.
I thought so too. I haven't been able to find the concept art because if I could, I would have already made a video about it.
Yeah, I thought it was on Twitter is where I saw it.
Maybe I need to dig deeper.
Yeah.
I know that they were keeping the game hush-hush, but they had that little red book tease with the tower and the wolf face and the flame, and then he opens the book and it's blank. So there was that little quick tease last year, and then there was a confirmation of a writer doing some codex entries and writing some backstory about the Qunari people. That was maybe last month or something. But so that makes the game official. So I would have thought that they would at least thrown up a few concept art images with a little bit of, you know, that music that we would so recognize, mm-hmm. with maybe just a quick narration and saying, or even just this, even saying, we will, at the very end, they could have done this. They could have said, to close this conference, we're going to leave you with some images that might inspire you what we will be showing next year. Mm-hmm. And then they pull up a bit of concept art with some Dragon Age music for everyone to recognize and to be like, ooh, ah, you know. But they didn't do that.
Yeah. I love that Inquisition theme.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Whole soundtrack.
Yeah. I'm sure you've probably seen it, but have you seen the Lindsey Stirling video?
Oh, yeah. It's amazing.
That's a great video.
Oh, yeah.
All right, guys. Well, I think we will officially go ahead and wrap this up. So, once again, thank you all so much for watching. And stay tuned for three conferences tomorrow. Should be a lot of fun. Hopefully, we'll get some interesting stuff.
More interesting than tonight's conference.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, everybody have a fantastic rest of your evening or day wherever you are in the world. And we will see you next time. Thanks for watching. And have fun.
Take care.